Hey everyone, welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you how to do pretty much what you're seeing right now, which is pretty much just mimicking what the Instagram profile looks like, you know, the whole picture thing. I mean, you can also see this in hashtags and stuff like that, but just basically the Instagram styled grid view of images that you're seeing right now. I'm going to hit the save button and it's going to go back to, you know, looking really bad again, but don't worry, I'm going to show you exactly how to put it back into what you just saw. And it's super simple. The first thing I want you to notice is that the widget that I'm using right here is gridview.count. There are a few other options for gridview, like builder, custom, and extent, but for this case, count will work just fine. You get the scroll features, and honestly, you pretty much get everything you need and want. In fact, what I'm going to do to make this Instagram-like is not even going to be here, because I made this as simple as possible. Obviously, there's way more practical ways to go about it than creating a list of image widgets. That I just made this to simplify it as most as I possibly could. So this is just basically a list, and all the images are like this. Just this, okay? The only thing that changes is this number, as you can see, because of the images are over here. If you don't know how to put images into your project, then just click on the video on the top right now and you will learn how to do it, so don't worry about that. So what is going on around here right now is that we're pretty much just displaying the image asset just as simply and plainly as we possibly can, and that kind of makes the images, you know, use their own format, and that's why they're not all the same size, and also that's why they're not all sticking together. So the secret to this is actually to come over here and use the fit property and then use box fit.cover. This is actually what would fix it. In fact, I'm going to save this now and watch this image right here, which is image one. Watch what happens to it. Now it's occupying all of its own space. So if all of the images are behaving like this, then we get the Instagram style grid view. Just with this code, just gridview.count. And then this right here is important because Instagram has a 3 amount of cross-axis count. If we do 1, then the grid becomes just 1, as you can see. So it's pretty much a column like this. If it's 2, you know, you get this. You know, if it's 5, I think you know what I mean by now. This is how it works. So Instagram just uses 3. Let's use 3 as well. And as you can see, there is scroll. So don't worry about that. And I already have a second list right here with everything, all the images saying boxfit.cover. So let's just copy that name and put it over here. And by the way, if you don't know what this is pretty much a spread operator. And what's going on is it is spreading out all of the widgets of this list right here. Okay, so pretty much this right here, all of it, the whole list is literally what is, like, I could copy this and just replace it like this, but this is the equivalent to it. That's pretty much what the spread operator is. But anyway, I'm going to save it and suddenly everything's going to be just like Instagram. Boom, just like that. And now we have, you know, all the images are equally distributed when it comes to space and stuff like that. And, you know, this is pretty much what we wanted. But in case you don't want to actually mimic exactly like Instagram, here's a couple of other options that you have to make it your own style. So first you have the main axis spacing, and by default it's 0. So if I save it like this, it stays the same, but I'm going to give it, let's say 20. And now there's space between the rows of the grid. So it's pretty simple. You know, main axis spacing grid wise is vertical, and you can just go wild if you want, make it 50. You know, it's up to you. I'm going to leave it at like 10. So it's not too much. And then you have the cross axis spacing, which is literally the same thing except horizontal. So if I do 50, this is what you get, you know, 20, this is what you get, and 10, this is what you get. So you can do it your own. As you can see, this wouldn't look as bad, especially, you know, if you had like a cool design or whatever, I don't know. But the point of this video is to make it like Instagram. So here you go. And I just realized I did not update this. It's been like this all the whole time. Let me just update it. Boom, there it is. I'm sorry for that mistake, my bad. But what matters is that you now know how to create your very own image Instagram picture style grid. So I hope this was able to help you. I hope you can use this in one of your projects or whatever. If this video did help you, please hit that like button And if you're a beginner trying to learn more and more about Flutter, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well so that you can get notifications on any future videos. That will be all for today. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.